If you're scared of being kidnapped or decapitated or anything like that, forget about that.
Welcome to How to Expat. My name is Tasha.
My name is Sam, and today we're going to talk about what actually scares us here about living in Colombia. And we're going to put that kind of video in kind of three segments. So what scared us before we came, what kind of the preconceptions we had, what scared us in the process of settling down, and then what really kind of scares us now that we live here full time since many months. So we start with security. So of course that's the thing. I think for you too that was the biggest thing. So we traveled to many countries in Europe, US and South America or Latin America, like Jamaica, Dominican Republic, places that are way more dangerous than Colombia. And still, when we came here after spending 2 months in Ecuador, we still were quite okay. Now let's see what kind of this Colombia that everybody talks about is really about. So I don't know, how was it for you, kind of?
Well, I have to add there that like family and friends were not helping at all. Because like the first reaction is like Colombia, like for real. And when traveling to Jamaica, it was like, oh nice, you're going to Jamaica.
That's kind of weird, right?
Yeah, it is. It's just like, I'm not saying that Jamaica is super like dangerous and something, but I just felt super different in Jamaica than living here actually. So I'm just saying like, I feel more safe here in comparison. So the thing is just like, I think it's just like the misunderstandings or like the misconceptions of what Colombia or how Colombia actually is in terms of safety. Because the only thing as always is like they think about drugs and kidnapping and all that like crime things when they hear Colombia, but not the beautiful aspects of Colombia. So I think this is like the TV was like brainwashing every single person, including myself, about it. So I think this was like, that was like the biggest problem, like our misconceptions about the country itself.
Yeah, and then the other thing which is also security related is are the guerrillas. So we didn't know, are they still active, what's exactly going on if you go to the countryside, if they're still there and stuff. And when we actually came, there was still a little bit more activities of all of these kinds of things around, but still, like it's at the time and now even less, it's kind of a non-factor here if you're not, I don't know, an indigenous person or somebody out in the countryside way
like
far.
A farmer, yeah.
Exactly. So yeah, they have these issues, but they're way outside where we live. So yeah, that's kind of the second thing. And then the third thing is, maybe you can explain that a little bit. Every time that we hear kind of a bang here, we thought it was gunshots. So yeah, can you explain what's
Colombians
going on?
Colombians love fireworks. Yeah. Which doesn't help when you come to a new country and you're super scared about safety and stuff, and then you hear like a bang there, and like I never shot a gun or something, so I don't know how that sounds like, but I just heard like really loud bangs from everywhere and like really often, like almost every day at that time. So I was like, wow, it's really dangerous here. And so we actually asked people like, what is it? And they're like, fireworks. Usually it's fireworks. I think actually I never heard a gunshot here. It's always fireworks. So yeah, I was like really paranoid about that. And also like when we like 3 weeks after coming here, I saw someone painting the floor, like on the street,
in
a parking lot actually, and I thought, oh my god, somebody got killed, they're like painting the shape of the dead person and stuff. No, they were just repainting the parking lot, you know, like I was that kind of paranoid.
I think an important thing to realize is that not every day somebody gets killed in this city of 4 million people. So yeah, I thought that's every day maybe 10 people get killed somewhere outside in the barrios, but it's really not that way. So it's just, yeah, these are the preconceptions we had.
Yeah.
Then once we came here, we settled, our fears turned quite in a different direction. So when we settled and we wanted to make it happen here in Colombia, next to how we make money is kind of the fear we had of if we would be able to get a visa, which for a lot of people in our age that don't receive a retirement or a kind of military pension or anything like that, yeah, it's scary. So fall in love with the country, and yeah, for our age group without a pension, it's not so easy to get a visa here so you can stay long term. So that was a big fear we had. And then the next thing, once we figured that out, we were kind of, we knew that we were most probably going to get it, the tax thing. So we went all through the details about taxes. And at one point I was like, I had prepared a whole Excel sheet of my tax situation because multinational tax situation is never easy. And I was like, no, we can't do that. Like, we pay way too much taxes. We have to go through another country like Panama or Costa Rica or something like that. We won't work for 50% just for the government. So that was really scary. These couple of moments that we fell in love, we wanted to stay, and then these kind of details came out to be kind of the scary. At the end of the day, we got our visa. At the end of the day, tax situation, after talking with an accountant, we figured out that it's not really too big of a burden. So yeah, that was kind of the scary moments in the settling down part.
Yeah, totally.
Then what we are scared now as kind of living fluent in Spanish, knowing the culture, people here in Colombia, is first of all the traffic. So I always tell our clients on our sneak peek services, so don't forget, if you want to find out if Medellin is the expat place for you, we offer a service where Tasha and I will show you the city. But anyway, so what I always tell on these tours is that if you're scared of being kidnapped or decapitated or anything like that, forget about that. Think about the traffic safety. So the motos, the taxi drivers, they're really horrible. So
they are. It's just like just crossing the street. Like so, like usually you have a red light, but we don't. Like usually the cars, they do, and we don't. So you're just gonna run because you never know when it's gonna turn like green. And the other thing is like, you never know if they really saw you, so you really want to make sure to run. Like, at least I'm like scared because you never know, did that motorcycle see you, did that car see you? And so I just run because like sometimes they're really fast, like coming fast, so you really don't want to get hit. So yeah, I think like it's really
the
law of the jungle. What?
The holes.
Oh yeah, the holes. Like you can just walk on the sidewalk and you have like big holes in the middle of the sidewalk. So you really have to watch your step here too. True, yeah.
That's the one thing. Then the other thing, I'm not really worried about, but
cat
this is
calling.
Yeah, it's a thing for
well,
his cat calling.
It's not like I'm scared, but it's just like something that makes a woman in general uncomfortable. And the thing is like usually we're together all the time, but when I walk our dog by myself or I'm just going out with girls and like on the way to see them, it's just like it's not comparable to other countries. Like as I like in Latin countries, yes, but like in Western countries, no. So it's just like they're more direct. Like they really like show you like I'm interested in you, or they like, even tell you like I had a guy coming up to me and like I always wanted a girlfriend with that hair, and I was like, oh wow, and like he was like that close. So it's kind of scary because you never know like what is the consequence when you just ignore them or when you say something. So that's just the scary part of it. But in general, I'm not scared about it. It's just like uncomfortable in general. So.
Yeah, that's really, really a thing. And then the other thing is we don't live really in a rich neighborhood or anything like that. And what we see is in Colombian or Colombian Spanish, it's called pelados. So if you know what a pelado is, hats off to you. You already know a lot. But yeah, these are kind of the young kind of gangster type with the hip hop clothes and stuff, standing on the street, kind of drinking way too much, taking drugs. So yeah, I don't know, how is that for you?
Well, when I'm with him, I'm okay, but I just like to avoid those kind of people because you never know actually how they react when they see you and stuff. And when I'm by myself, I'm like even avoiding them even more, like walking two blocks more instead of like crossing the street and seeing those people, because you never actually know how they react and you never know what kind of drugs they're consuming. So you never know if like they're gonna be aggressive or something. So just like it never happened something to me or to us, but it's just like precautious, let's say.
Yeah. Exactly, I would say same way.
Precaution, yeah.
So yeah, kind of a different change of kind of things that scare us here in Colombia, living here. Really, at the moment, what scares us, I think what, a lot of people will say once they actually live here, not the preconceptions and not that kind of a weary situation once you kind of fell in love and want to settle down and not quite sure if you can get that. What people really, or yeah, what us at least scares here is really the traffic and yeah, the cat calling and then maybe the young gangsters if you're in the neighborhood like that.
Sounds so funny that we're scared of the traffic.
Yeah, it's really, that's the thing. That's, it's not the gunshots. It's not that we're scared of getting killed. Of course, people get robbed and sometimes here, but yeah, that's not the thing, the primary thing we're scared of. We're scared of crossing the street.
Yeah.
So you kind of see how that changes and how maybe life could be for you when you would live in Colombia, and that the preconception is not at all what you will get here. So yeah, that was pretty much it. Again, if you want to find out if Medellin is the expat destination for you, check out the sneak peek tour. The link is in the description down below.